Now, Verity is a woman who took the road less traveled. She found a novel way of funding, marketing, and promoting her album, aptly titled Journey. This debut album encapsulates the story of how the Cape Town-based singer and songwriter discovered her love for music, and she joins us on the program this morning. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you. It's great to be here.
Now, you use some very interesting strategies to, first of all, produce your album and to market it. Could you just tell us a little bit about that story?
When I discovered it was going to cost 300,000 rand to record an album before I'd even marketed it, and looked that South African musicians weren't necessarily selling enough albums to make that money back, I realized I needed to get creative. So I had an idea that I would sell the album on my website, iamverity.com, before I recorded it. So I asked people to buy something that didn't exist, and I said, you know, when enough people have bought it, then I'll record it, and 10.6% of the proceeds will go to charity as I go. So I raised money for Power and also for the Live Your Dreams Foundation, helping other musicians get started in the music industry.
Wow, and you convinced 2,000 people to invest in an album that didn't even exist.
I did. 2,000 people in 25 countries stepped up and said yes to buying this album. They voted for which songs I should record. They chose the name.
Wow.
So they really created it with me.
Now, you recorded or wrote your first song when you were a psychology student at UCT. What was your intention with that song?
I didn't really have an intention. It was my 20th birthday, and I was just thinking about my life and where I wanted to go as a psychologist. And out of nowhere, I just had lyrics, well, words came to me. And when I wrote them down, I looked at it and I was like, wow, these are lyrics.
Yeah.
So it was very unexpected. I always say music chose me. I didn't choose music.
Yeah, always the case. It just seeps through your pores.
Yeah.
Now, you were born musical, you say. It's a craft you learned along the way. Just speak to us very briefly about your journey as a musician.
From that first song, I kept writing lyrics for years, right through my degree. Eventually got the courage to go for singing lessons. And from there, it took a long time to have the courage to stand on stage. It was quite a journey for me. This was a very unexpected career choice.
Yeah.
So I went to the States, I took a demo over there, I got a manager there, I got a performance coach, I won some competitions, singing competitions there, and then came back to Cape Town, where I put a band together and then started this journey of the Lucky Pocket Project to create an album with people, do something different, make a difference.
Yeah.
And yeah, seeing where it goes next is going to be the interesting part.
Wow. Now, one of my favorites on the album is Forever in Me, which is a song that you dedicated to your father.
Yeah.
Now, what is the most valuable lesson that your father taught you that you carry with you to this day?
Wow, I think my father's ability to pioneer and to innovate. He was always someone who's looking for solutions to problems, and he could make something like cleaning the windows a challenge. So he would go out and he'd time himself, and all of a sudden he could turn something that was mundane into a challenge, into something exciting. So trying to remember to do that with the things that have come sometimes take a little bit of time, just saying, well, where's the innovation in this? How can I do this differently?
Yeah. Now, when other people would have just simply given up or gone the conventional route, you decided to get creative. Now, where do you get this fierce determination to succeed?
Definitely from my family. We're a family of big thinkers, big dreamers. We paint with a bold brush. And
yeah.
I was always a big thinker. I wasn't a big doer. So this has been my first big step of going, right, I've had a crazy idea, now I'm going to act on it.
Yeah.
And I'm so glad that I did. I've just learned so much.
Yeah. Well, you're fierce in more ways than one. Tell us about that 800-kilometer walk across Spain.
Wow. that was the start of this. That was after after my dad passed away. That was my way to remember him.
Yeah.
And also to really prove to myself that I was capable of starting something and finishing it. So it was 800 kilometers by myself across Spain, learning to speak Spanish, learning to walk. And when I got to the other end, I was like, well, if I can do this, I'm sure I can do anything.
Yeah. Now, what would you say has been the most defining moment of your entire career to now?
Wow. Goodness. There's been a few. I think taking that first step, you know, the album's called Journey, and I've said every journey starts with the first step. And I think taking the step of being bold enough to tell people I had a dream and put it out there, and then just put out a website saying I'm selling an album that doesn't exist. Does anyone want to support me? That was, you know, doing that was the moment.
Yeah.
When I really showed that I was committed to making this happen. And nothing happens unless we make that commitment. So
yeah. Thank you so much for inspiring me, Verity. And thank you for joining us this morning.
Thank you.
Well, Verity discussing her debut album entitled Journey, and her story really just reminds us that anything is possible. Now, if you've missed her first performance, stay tuned for more, and don't forget to let us know what you think of her music or anything you've seen on the program. Email your thoughts to weekendlive@sabc.co.za or fax us on 011-714-5193. Back after the break.
friend long into luxurizing. Everybody else's mistake shouted down. Watched our reflections frowning from glaring deep-rooted opinions again. If we raise our voices just enough. If we raise our voices just enough. Someone will be listening. Oh. Walk down the street, hurling abuse across town, interfering in ideas that were not ours, not hearing a word. Our mouths just kept on moving, hoping our ideas would be heard. If we raise our voices just enough. If we raise our, if we raise our, if we raise our voices, well, someone will be listening. Oh. Coffee shops, station stops, dinner tables and TV services expound what we were told in the first place.